Hello. This is my submission for Necromancer Condor Triathlon. A quick explanation. Condor is the crypto online racing league. A lot of active racers, and this category is meant to show off most commonly run characters Condor events. Gonna be Cadence, Melody, Bard. All three of these are characters that can be fast, especially Bard, which generally probably one of the best suited characters raw speed. If this category is accepted, I highly recommend it, only accepting it as a race with Oblivion 111. Again, these characters are selected based on how well they fare in a setting, both for enjoyment for the players as well as enjoyment to the viewers. In this case, we would be running seeded mode. We'd be generating three seeds on the at the site of the race. We know these seeds in advance. This is just being done in order to minimize damages if any player takes an unexpected death. They'll be able to rerun the same seed up to the point where they died fairly quickly. It'll also keep the races, the two racers, as fair as possible by offering them the same layouts with the same items. Anyway, this was already for advance. Commentate over it because I can't really commentate while playing this. In the case of SVG, I will have someone else commentate for me on the couch, so commentary is not a concern. So, anyway, first character is Cadence, which is the character. Starts with just the base dagger. Hit 1 tile and fight for 1 damage. Here we're finding a titanium dagger though, which is just straight upgrade. Same attack range, but fighting extra bombs there. Bombs are especially important on Cadence for boss strategies, especially her final boss, the Necromancer. You want lots of bombs for that because you want to be able to blast through the stage. Trapdoors, obviously a pretty fast way to advance quickly through the game as they boot you immediately. You have to deal with this quote-unquote penalty box where you fight the boss on the previous floor if you didn't kill him before. But these are generally pretty easy to handle as long as you're familiar with them. Booze has a super fast quick kill ability that probably throwing your dagger and then bombing him, but it's somewhat unsafe. Though in a marathon setting I'd be doing out a majority of the pieces and probably bump them. I need a black chest for a better weapon, and I find quite possibly the best weapon in the game is Obsidian Cat. Obsidian Cat is going to do damage based on multiplier. Also going to let you kind of slide along the sides of enemies while attacking them. You're going to see kind of a lot here. You know, pilot can gold on the ground in order to summon a leprechaun. Killing a leprechaun provides some gold and a lucky charm. A lucky charm will prevent bats from randomly attacking. Bats are fully random in their movement, so pretty hard to predict, but if you have the lucky charm, they will only attack if absolutely forced to, if they have no other movement options but to move. So, also finding the Shrine of Darkness on the last floor, which is quite possibly the best shrine in the game, grants a compass map and the Ring of Darkness. The Ring of Darkness has this visual effect you see here, but more importantly, lets you take any items from shops for free. Lets you completely rob them. I would like those Boots of Pain because they provide an alternate way of dealing damage, but unfortunately, the Boots of Pain deal 1.5 parts of damage on your own, and I tend to pass them. Finding a potion there, which is essentially an extra life, if I ever hit a point where I would die, instead it is consumed and restored. Also worth noting that the Shrine of Darkness removes all wall forges from the rest of the game, greatly reducing visibility and reducing enemy aggro since they have a harder time seeing. But since I have the map, it's in my way is not a problem at all, despite the lack of lighting. Getting off the Ring of Darkness by taking a shrine or shielding from my purple moss chest. It's gonna let me see again. To tell what's going on. And Ring of Shielding also going to provide me with one pretty good. Next enemy that hits me will instead break the ring. Do no damage, and the ring will cast a greater shield spell. Dealing with death metal here, it's fine. Death metal is the fastest song in the game. Finding a transmute spell, not something I tend to remember to do, but not really something I will need much use of at this point, since I have most of what I want. Get right there. And transiting that route so I can get the spell, which is very useful. Accidentally using the wrong spell there. I meant to use my previous spell, but I accidentally used transient, which did absolutely nothing. So, gotta take a hit for that, and that's gonna break my ring of shielding. Zone 4 at this point. Zone 4 being kind of a technical zone with lots of things that they can very strongly. The warlocks switch places with you on death. These ooze golems drop ooze tiles that cause the player to shrink and become unable to deal damage or take. And they also double all damage intake while standing up here, so you have to be very careful around these. Good way to die very quickly. Deadfinger is a bit of a first boss. Boss comes first right before the Necrodancer. All four bells in the stage have to be running. Deadfinger has to be through the charging dog. Pretty fast fight, but you know what you're doing. Yeah. As for the Necrodancer fight here, normally you're supposed to align the both characters on these button puzzles in order to destroy the stage, but with some bombs in hand, you can skip that part pretty easily. And also by doing this and moving lots of enemies on stage, for the second phase, which we just started, Necromancer is coming up against the spawn limitation for the fight, and you can't summon any enemies at all, which makes for this second phase quite easy. Also see if they manipulate the Necromancer's AI to get them to move closer with me, just close enough for me to hit him before he moves away again. But that's gonna be it for Cadence. So next character, I have another seed already pre-generated for, is Melody. Melody is forced to only use the gold. Saw it at the end of that last round. The golden loot is locked in at 1 damage, can never do more, and can only attack while moving. It can't be used to attack enemies directly, but whenever Melody moves, every tile surrounding both her old and new destination acts for 1 damage. It's makes her very good at handling large swarms of enemies very efficiently. Going into the arena here, I'm trying to bring a piece. Very strong find for Nobby. Bring up pieces in a straightforward range. This leaves the moths spawn on every floor, and also weakens Luchador's mini boss into the form of that mini boss. So, for instance, dragons will always be green dragons. Banshees will always be blue banshees. Will always be nightmares if not blood nightmares. Piece also provides an empty heart container, which is putting off Coral Rift. I'm going to be finding a black chest to try and get better armor. Fortunately, I find glass armor, which is arguably not better than leather armor. Glass armor, going to protect against one hit, preventing damage completely, and then it breaks, leaving nothing at all. Whereas leather armor is a consistent 0.5 reduction in damage for every incoming hit. But decided to stick with glass armor for now. Stick with it. See the power of the Ram Piece here. Normally that Minotaur would have been a Dark Minotaur with 5 HP, but instead, thanks to the Ram Piece, 3 HP as a Light Minotaur. Checking the shop here, finding Miner's Cap, which is probably the best item to find this Melody. Again, Melody requiring movement in order to attack, and so that Miner's Cap is going to need to dig surrounding walls automatically, giving her plenty of room to move around. Vault. Also going to save a lot of time in terms of just not having to dig at all. Without Miner's Cap, you're forced to stop and stand still for every time you want to dig a wall. Miner's Cap just gonna be able to dig on the go. Very helpful for reaching the exit quickly. Scroll here, kind of unintentionally using the wrong item here. Place the bomb to break the crate open. I do eventually though, but create Canadian Heart Transplant, which is gonna give you a little bit of a preview for what's gonna happen in the next character, Bard. Heart Transplant gives you a temporary 20-second removal of the rhythm mechanic. It allows you to move as fast or as slow as you want for that duration. Enemies will only move after you do. Finding the Zara Charm, which is going to block the spawning of the randomly generated baits. Not the King Konga. Killing the Konga line is generally a pretty trivial task for Melody, but it's still going to be faster to unlock this to get Konga off his throne and because King Konga will teleport after every hit if it doesn't click him. So, and he has 4 HP in that form, and Melody is stuck in 1 damage with the blue, so I want to burst him down with a bomb if possible, rather than having to deal with him teleporting 4 times. Right here we're going to get a nice demonstration of why magic in general is so powerful in Melody. Magic requires kills to recharge and be used again. But Melody's attack, blue attack, lets her get kills to recharge it constantly on the go. So, you can see on the last floor, even though I was only focusing on taking out the mini boss, the Ogre, and Sarcophagus, so this time fire, ended up getting about an additional 5 or 6 kills out of them those. And my freeze spell is already, being recharged several times over. And I'm on Necromancer fight, Grimaldi. Grimaldi, this fight is considerably different, although it does, much of the Necromancer's AI is the same. It'd still be the same lure, pulling approach. Trick him into moving close enough for you to hit him. But otherwise, it's a lot more hectic of a fight, having to deal with lots of enemy spawns. And this last phase is very easily defeated with the Spear Scroll. You normally have to take out the Scum Pushman Claw, but the Spear Scroll you can just take that hot bath anyway. That's the end of Melody. Now we're on to the last character of the triathlon. Under the wrong stairs here. Over to the seeded and reset seed. Again, seeded is only being done to give both racers a fair shake and also to make rerunning that the bosses are minimized. So, I'm going to check my shop here, finding a very set of good items. So, I'm gonna be taking all that. I have to kill the shopkeeper though, but I don't really mind. So, Bard, as I've mentioned before, it's a character where you go as fast or as slow as you want to. Enemies will only move after you do. So, probably be one of the fastest characters in the game. And, again, the bug with the heal. As you enter exit stairs, you are fully invincible, and that extends the cost of blood healing. With other characters, like Cadence, you can only get off one blood heal, because you just, your input, you use the heal spell, still has to be in time with the rhythm. But Bard, since he has no rhythm mechanic, can pretty much just mash the heal button upon stepping downstairs and get a full heal every single floor if he did. So, Bard, very quick skill. Involving rangers. It all works under certain circumstances, but I did take the time upon entering the arena to make sure that the opener that I got was one that would work. Sure enough, it was, so that makes for a very fast fight. Hip piece again. Shot on Melody, and now we're seeing her Bard again. Weaker bosses, less enemies. It's really helpful in speedrunning. On to Zone 4 already. Much faster time than the other character. It's just by virtue of being able to mash like crazy. More to say about this. Zone 4 is going to be kind of squirrely, being forced to spend a bomb there to get to that wall. Maybe could have gone all along, around the long way, but, a bit of a mistake there. Gotta watch those Warlocks. Warlocks, again, popping places with you when you kill them. That can put you in some bad situations. That's what resulted in my Crown of Teleportation breaking and teleporting to the shop. have to be careful when approaching you on horizontals of things like that. Fire pig, shrink bed, fire trap. I'm gonna use my ham after taking that blast. But almost done with this run. Quick mini boss. Pushing my way into the exit. Final boss for Bart's Hellas character's boss, so he just gets the last of the main four bosses at the run. And that's it. That is the Condor Triathlon.
That was a pretty good set of runs.
Cadence, Melody, and Bard. Again, I would not be providing commentary myself while running this. I would have people on the couch doing commentary for me. And also, again, I only recommend using this category. Again, these are the characters most commonly used in the Condor Cryptonecrodancer Online Racing League. And for good reason. They make for a lot of really close, really intense races. All three very fast characters with a lot of for some pretty impressive speedruns. So, again, highly recommend considering this as a race with them. That's going to be it for now, so thanks for watching.